Now that we've learned how to take derivatives of functions of multiple variables, now we're going to start learning how to integrate functions of multiple variables. In particular, if you have a function of x and y, you might integrate it over a two-dimensional region. And if you have a function of x, y, and z, you might integrate it over three-dimensional regions. The question is, what does a two or three-dimensional integral mean? And the slogan, just like with one-dimensional integrals, is the whole is the sum of the parts. So what we're going to do in this video is we're going to review how that applies to one-dimensional integrals, and then in the next video, we're going to take the same ideas and apply that to a two-dimensional integral. So, review of one-dimensional integrals. The whole idea of a one-dimensional integral is to figure out a bulk quantity. It's how much stuff is there between x equals a and x equals b. Now, a favorite example of stuff is area. You find the area under a curve. But we've also seen that integrals can give you volumes, it can give you masses, it can give you moments of inertia, it can give you the total amount of money, if f of x is the rate at which the money is coming in, it can give you distance. There are lots and lots of things that we can get by doing an integral. So we're going to talk about stuff in general. How much stuff is there between x equals a and x equals b? And what we need is we need to know a way to compute the amount of stuff in a little interval. So we need to have a function that gives us how much stuff we have per unit length. Now, if you care about area, then f is just the height, because the area of a rectangle is height times width. Area per unit length is height. But if you want to figure out volume, then f, the thing you're going to integrate, is the area. If you're trying to figure out mass, the thing you integrate is the density, because the density is the mass per unit length. If you want to figure out the total amount of money from an income stream, then f is the rate at which the money is coming in. If you want to figure out the distance you travel, then f is your velocity. In this case, we usually call the variable t for time instead of calling it x. In fact, we often call the distance x. But still, what we're integrating is the rate at which stuff is coming in. And the classic picture is that of area under a curve. Actually, for any of these, we've just said that the amount of stuff in a little interval is f of x times delta x. So if you draw this, the whole idea is we are going to chop this region into pieces. And strictly speaking, we're breaking the interval from a to b into pieces. And we're going to say how much stuff is there in each little interval, and then we're going to add them up. Now, of course, for the area problem, we know that the area of this little strip is the height times the width. But if we were doing volume, we'd want the area times the width. And if we were doing mass, we'd want the density times the width. If we were doing money, we'd want the income rate times the amount of time. So in each case, the contribution is going to be f of x times delta x. So we break our interval from a to b into n pieces. And how big are the n pieces? Well, the total length is b minus a. So the length of each piece is b minus a over n. We call that delta x. And then we label a bunch of points. Our starting point is a plus delta x, a plus 2 delta x, a plus 3 delta x, xn is a plus n delta x, which is b. And then we pick a point, we call it xi star. Some point in the ith interval, it's going to be the representative of that whole interval. And there are several rules for picking that representative. There's the left endpoint rule, where x1 star is really x0, and x2 star is x1, and x3 star is x2. You could use the right endpoint, or you could use the midpoint. In fact, the midpoint is probably the most accurate of the two, even though it's sometimes easier to do the calculations using left endpoints or right endpoints. And then we say, how much stuff is there in the ith interval? Well, f tells you the stuff per unit length. Delta x is the length. So the total amount of stuff in the ith interval is roughly f of xi star times delta x. The total amount of stuff period is the sum. And this isn't exact because the amount, f is not a constant over each little interval. It varies a little bit. And we can get around that by slicing things finer and finer and finer and finer. So the exact answer is the limit as n goes to infinity of this sum. This thing's called a Riemann sum. And that, by definition, is the integral from a to b of f of x dx. And let me just close with a slightly different notation for the same integral. Instead of thinking of it going from a to b, let's think of it as an integral over the interval. What's the region that we're integrating over? The interval from a to b. And this is a different notation for the same thing. Okay, in the next video, we'll see how the same ideas apply in two dimensions.